Dear friends, a very warm welcome to a 40-day journey through Lent with me, Father Joseph Royan, a Redemptorist. This is going to be a time of spiritual renewal and transformation.
40-day journey through Lent, day 37.
As little kids, we remember that we were often told that the Wednesday of the Holy Week was known as Spy Wednesday. From that time on, Spy Wednesday has always had a distinct place in my mind. I learned later that Spy Wednesday was not an official liturgical designation but one of popular origin. It's easy enough to see how people came up with the name. Judas kept looking for a way to hand Jesus over. Judas Iscariot is the ultimate enigma. As Holy Week comes around each year, it is only natural for us to seek more information about this man whose name has become synonymous with treachery and betrayal. We know for sure that Judas was one of the 12, specially chosen by Jesus to be his disciple. We have no reason to doubt that he received the same training as the other disciples did. All four evangelists tell us that he was the betrayer of Jesus. Matthew in today's gospel passage tells us that he hanged himself. Though the gospel accounts indicate that the initiative to betray Jesus always comes from Judas, they do not offer us any clear understanding of his motive. John's gospel gives a clue that greed may have been the source of Judas's downfall. It was Judas, among others, who loudly complained when Mary anointed the feet of Jesus with costly perfume. He did not say this out of concern for the poor, but because he was a thief. He held the community purse and used it to help himself to what was deposited there. It is clear too from John's Gospel chapter 12 verses 14 and 15 that Judas worked out a financial deal with the chief priests before agreeing to hand him over. And we hear that in today's Gospel passage. They paid him 30 pieces of silver, and from that time on, he kept looking for an opportunity to hand Jesus over. Jesus' condemnation of the act of Judas is about as severe as one could imagine. The Son of Man is departing, as Scripture says of him, but woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. Better for him if he had never been born. Yet the church has admonished preachers and teachers not to say that Judas or any other individual person is definitely in hell. Matthew does say that Judas experienced remorse or regret over his betrayal and flung the money back into the temple. Dear friends, I'm reminded of a little verse by an anonymous author. It goes like this. Still as of old, man by himself is priced. For 30 pieces, Judas sold himself, not Christ. Yes, my dear friends, Judas did not betray Jesus. He betrayed himself. Judas did not sell Jesus. He sold his very soul for 30 pieces of silver. Perhaps that is the most basic lesson of Spy Wednesday. We have been called to be faithful disciples of the Lord. His grace is sufficient for our discipleship. To betray Jesus is, in the most profound sense, to destroy our very selves. Let us pray. Lord, help us to be faithful to you, and let us not be carried away by our passions, our selfishness. And help us, Lord, today to recommit ourselves in love and fidelity to you. Make this prayer to Christ our Lord. Amen. God bless you.